Children's Royal Variety Performance.
I do end up in some of the strangest places, don't I? There's the most magical atmosphere here tonight. I can't tell you. There are jugglers and fire eaters and very tall men in stilts. And that's just for starters. Backstage is some of your favourite children's entertainment. They're going to bring you a night, hopefully, you'll never forget. And we're not only here to entertain children today, we're here to help them. It's for the NSPCC who help children, as you know. We're aiming to raise lots of money. They had a record-breaking year last year. They helped over 50,000 children. Let's hope they have an even better year next year. Now, of course, the president of the NSPCC is Her Royal Highness, the Princess Margaret, and I think the royal car is about to arrive now.
There's Princess Margaret getting out of the car, her lady in waiting in the background. She's met by Mr. John Avery, the general manager of Stolmos Theatres, and he's introducing her now to Mr. Louis Benjamin, who's president of the organising committee for tonight's performance. Makes her way through the foyer and introduced there to Mr. Michael Moore, the chairman of the NSPCC's Central Executive Committee, Dr. Alan Gilmore, the director of the NSPCC, Lady Harris, the chairman of the organising committee for tonight's show, Mr. Kevin Jones, the chairman and chief executive of Mothercare, who sponsored tonight's event. Mrs. Jones, next to her husband. And then the princess greets Jonathan Powell, the controller of BBC One Television, and then Mr. James Moyer, head of light entertainment at the BBC. Quite a guard of honour to go through now, composed of clowns, children's entertainers, members of the Magic Circle. She then meets members of the organising committee, including in the background Mr. Billy Marsh, the vice president as well as associate producer of tonight's performance. And then finally to receive a bouquet of flowers from Christopher Sadler, the grandson of Lady Harris, before she's escorted into the auditorium. Such an occasion and the wonderful star of so many popular children's films, Mr. David Tomlinson.
Your Royal Highness, my lords, ladies and gentlemen, do you like the suit? Now, you will realize, ladies and gentlemen, that they wanted somebody very special to open the show tonight. They were hoping for a charismatic character, clean living, decent, charming, handsome, wonderfully clever, generally speaking, an all-round wonderful chap. Well, here I am, ladies and gentlemen. Need I say more? With all due modesty, ladies and gentlemen, I do have all those attributes. And of course, I'm well known for being the only actor living who can swim underwater and sing at the same time. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my small contribution to this evening's performance is to welcome you most warmly to this year's Children's Royal Variety Performance. And especially, I welcome most warmly those to whom this evening's entertainment belongs, the children. My wife, ladies and gentlemen, waved me off today, as wives do, and she said, well, my darling, I do hope that they're not all too young to remember you. But having had a good look at you, Most of you before my time.
Have this evening for you. First of all, we're coming on in a minute, will be the Liney Blair Low. This be a deep, jolly Liney, because Lionel flicky around the floor and deep smiley all the time, but not do the all, not the clue low. Oh no, no clue leaves from the Liney, but deeply smile, keeply go round all the time, deep flirtly up the air. Oh, this be nice. Then come on the Juggalo, deep and juggly round like this, and all the bally go up and dip, but droppy now and again, because in rehearsal, all the ball low droppily on the floor, ah, deep joy. Ah, but never mind, then Ross come on, all deeply twangly of the guitars, but be mimely, but they did play it in the studio earlier on. Never mind this B. Ah, yes, but there be the musicians. No, what the play? No, clappy load. No, no, no. This not be the clapply at the moment. Then later on, there be more the ballerina coming on. Ah, deep the Horton thing, the holiday money. And this be nice, because all floatly round and all the nervily backstairs, and then all Stanley in the line, and the royalty come down and deeply curtsily, bowly, ah, very nicely, thankfully, shuffly on, and then jumply into the Rolls Royce, quickly up the mount, in the bed, beat and kip low. Thank you very much. That's more or less what's going to happen. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to step in time. Enjoy the show. See you later. Yeah.
Piece of cake, a load of sweet. It's when afraid to speak when I was just alive. Me daddy gave me nose a tweet and said that I was bad. But then one day I learned a word that saved me aching nose. The biggest word you've ever heard, and this is how it goes.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always have to go.
There once was an ugly duckling.
There still is, nay.
No, there's not. He had feathers all stubby and sort of brown.
And tubby and green.
Now the other birds in so many words said quack, you better get out of town.
What?
They said quack, get out.
Quack, quack.
Get out.
Quack, quack.
Hey, get out of town. Everybody do the quacks, ready?
Quack.
Get out.
Quack, quack.
Come on, get out.
Quack, quack.
Get out of town.
They're good, aren't they?
Yeah.
I think they're all quackers.
All quackers. Well, this duck grew up to be beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, and everybody liked him.
They did.
Just like you.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. You see, you're not such an ugly little duckling.
No.
No feathers all stubby or brown. Well, everyone agrees that you are indeed the best birdie here in the town. And we say, you're the best. You're the best. You're the best in town. And you'll be so much better. Yes, I will if you try. So who's an ugly duckling?
Not I. Quack, quack.
Woo.
Curiouser and curiouser, I find I grow curiouser, but each time I no reply. Curiouser and curiouser, what does it mean?
Decisions, decisions, I've got to make decisions. I don't know what to do with the day. Shall I fill it with memories, or shall I throw it away? Decisions, decisions, I've gotta make decisions. I really ought to be on my way. A rabbit's life, it's a busy life. I've gotta make decisions. It's no good having visions. I gotta make decisions today. I like a nice cup of tea in the morning, or to start the day, you see. And at 11:30, well, my idea of heaven is a nice cup of tea. I like a nice cup of tea with my dinner, and a nice cup of tea with my tea. And when it's time for bed, there's a lot to be said for a nice cup of tea.
And there's a lot to be said for a nice glass of milk. Watch, I pour the milk into the glass, and this is where the hanky-panky comes in. I say the magic words, biff, puff, poof, and that is where the hanky-panky comes out. So let's tuck it in, and let's tuck it. What have we got here? Let's have a look. One banana. That's not much good, is it? One banana. Don't look sad, don't look soulful. Wave the one fruit. There's a bowlful. I like that trick. Now I've solved my friend's starvation. There's the table decoration. Now, oh, this next trick can be done by any 10-year-old with 15 years practice. I pour in the chocolate. I pour in the raspberry and the pistachio. I say the magic words, piff, puff, poof. Look at it!
The tablecloth trick!
What? Pull off the tablecloth?
Yes!
Shall I?
Yes!
Well, if you say so, here we go. One, two, 3. Yes!
It's a fly!
Can you really fly?
I'll teach you.
How do it?
Well, you just think lovely, wonderful thoughts, and up you go!
I'm flying, flying. Look at me, way up high. Suddenly, here am I. I'm flying. I'm flying, flying. I can soar, I can weave, and what's more, I'm not even trying. High up and as light as I can.
Cat and a silver cane, a watch of gold and a diamond chain. I can only do. You sleep till after two. You promenade with a big cigar. You tour the world in a private car. You dine on chicken and caviar. An actor's life for me.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Just before the show started, I call for three brave young volunteers who'd like to come up here and take part in a very silly little game. And I'd like you to meet our first volunteer, please. Give her a round of applause. Excellent. Thank you, Helen. This is Sarah. Okay, Sarah, you know the rules of the game. Let me explain to people at home. Sarah is going to attempt to identify a very famous celebrity by touch alone. Okay, so can we please meet our first celebrity? Now, First of all, can you please give Sarah one clue? Can you please put her hands on your most prominent feature? Right, okay. Now, will you mime what you're most famous for, please? Any ideas? What's it feel like?
Is it Frank Bruno?
That's not bad. What made you think of that?
He's got big muscles. I'm a bit chubby.
He's a what?
A bit chubby.
He's a bit chubby? So you think it's Frank Bruno? Okay, that's absolutely fair. I tell you what, celebrity, would you please take lovely Sarah just back over there? Thank you very much indeed. That's it. Back a bit, please. And now can we have our second contestant, please? Right, okay. Edward, looking forward to it?
Yeah.
Good man. Right, this is Edward. Can we please have our next celebrity? Okay, now can you please give Edward a clue by putting his hand on your most prominent feature? Please. I think you're going to enjoy this, Ed. Oh, yes, of course. Why didn't I think of that? Any ideas from there?
Margaret Thatcher.
Okay, I'll tell you, would you like to mime what you're most famous for, please, celebrity? Take a hold, take a hold. Right. Oh, that's a good clue. That's a good clue. Any ideas? What do you think she's doing?
Tensing her muscles.
She's what?
Tensing her muscles.
She's tensing her muscles. You think it's Margaret Thatcher tensing her muscles? Okay, Margaret, if you'd like to take Edward just over there, please, a bit further. Thank you. And can we have our third and final contestant, please? Give her a round of applause. And this is Caroline. Looking forward to it, Caroline? Good girl, okay. Right, can we please have our third and final celebrity, please? Okay. Okay, celebrity, what we'd like you to do, please, is to put Caroline's hand on your most prominent feature, please. Oh. Is that a clue? Any ideas?
It's his chin.
It's his chin, that's very quick. That's his most prominent feature. Now, would you please mime, celebrity, what you're most famous for? There we are. Oh, this is interesting. Oh! What do you think he's doing? I'll give you a clue. It's not Lionel Blair. Any idea? Give another clue. Give her one of these. And another one. Right, have a guess.
Is he doing exercises?
Is he doing exercise? Not bad, not bad. The bus is up. Have a quick guess. Who do you think it is? Anybody?
Kermit.
Kermit? Kermit the Frog, because he was bouncing around. That's a very good guess, actually. Okay, I'll tell you what, celebrities, would you please step forward, please, and bring your partners down with you? Just bring them a little bit closer, please, a little bit closer. Just over there, right? Okay, now let's just establish, I'm going to start over here. Now, you said... Who did you say, Edward, that you thought you were feeling?
Margaret Thatcher.
Margaret. So you'd be quite happy to kiss Margaret Thatcher, wouldn't you?
Okay.
So would you like to take your blindfold off and see who you were feeling? Well, actually, I'll let you into a little secret, but I don't want you to say anything. Yeah, you like it now, don't you? Let's go over now. I thought you would. Now to Caroline. Now, who did you say that you thought that you were with?
Kermit.
Kermit the Frog. What gave it away? Would you like to see what Kermit looks like? Okay. Now.
Hello.
It wasn't really quite Kermit, was it? No, but it's a very good guess. And finally, let's come to Sarah. Now, Sarah... Who did you think it was?
Frank Bruno.
And you thought he was a bit flabby?
Yes.
Okay, then would you please turn round and look at the face of Frank Bruno? Ladies and gentlemen, would you give our celebrities and our contestants a great big round of applause, please?
are probably wondering what I am doing here. Well, I will tell you, I am here to introduce some singing, some female singing, because I have a deep understanding of all that is good in modern music today. I became the natural choice to introduce the next part of the show. Now, when you think of exciting music combined with stunning beauty, only one name springs immediately to mind. And that...
Thank you. You're Royal Highness. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for my first number, I would like to sing...
Wait a minute. You stupid woman. What do you mean, for my next number, I would like to sing?
But I heard you introducing me. You said stunning music and exciting beauty. So naturally, I thought that you wanted me to sing before these wonderful people.
Why would I do a thing like that? What have they ever done to us to deserve such terrible retribution?
I am devastated. You are always so cruel to me.
Oh, heavens. Well, for God's sake, do not weep. All right. Look, don't shake your germs over the band. They'll put the depths in. No, listen. Listen, I tell you what. You let me introduce the next act, and then I will let you sing for me.
Oh, good. I will sing Under the Bridges of Paris.
And I will listen from here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure now to introduce to you not one, not two, but three very beautiful and talented young ladies. Singing their latest hit, I Want You Back, it's Bananarama.
The nearest you'll find to perfection in the world of juggling, Bob Gramson.
Thank you.
it was time for the brilliant puppets of Roger Stevenson and Harry S. Stewart.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's more. Did you have a good day today? Yeah?
Yeah?
I went fishing and I fell in. And a fella jumped in and pulled me out. He said, how did you come to fall in? I said, I didn't come to fall in, I came to fish. Do you think it's dangerous crossing the road these days, do you folks? A motor car knocked me down. He said, look out. I said, why, are you coming back? And a policeman ran over. He said, give me your name and I'll tell your family. I said, but my family know my name. He said, there's a zebra crossing up there. I said, well, I hope he's having better luck than I had. I was run over once by a mobile library. I said, ah. He said, shh. I'm a bit sad tonight, folks, and when I'm sad, I write little poems. I wrote one last week. I talk to the trees, the birds, and the flowers because I'm a lonely man. Last night I talked to a tulip, and they took me away in a van. There was a young man called Hardwick. By a billiard ball he was struck. When he was dead on his tombstone, it said, Hardwick, hard ball, hard luck. I got a letter from my mammy this week. Mammy said, dear son, I'm waiting to put the cat out, but he hasn't come in yet. Your Uncle John is getting worse. He put 6 new windows in before he realized he had a crack in his glasses. We've moved into a new house and there's no chimney pot. We have to carry the smoke out in buckets. It's a funny family next door. The girl is knock-kneed and the two boys are bow-legged. When they walk down the street with her in the middle, they spell OXO. Lots of happiness from your loving mammy. P.S. Your favourite song when you were a child was Thumbelina. Would you sing it at the Raw Command Show? Ah, ladies and gentlemen. Kids, come on. Here we go. Thumbelina, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance. Thumbelina, sing. Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small? When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet tall.
Ago. Let me tell you all about it. Now I don't want to bore you. What's it all about? Well, it all started out 'cause I turned on a Hamilton.
Oh,
that I heard one morning.
Hey.
It was a record some DJ played as I laid in bed. I never heard what he said as I laid there yawning. But before too long, this catchy little song was coming round around my head.
Here goes die-die, diddy-bumma, diddy-bumma, die-do. Fire, diddy-umma, dumma, diddy-umma, day. Tiddy-eye, tie, tiddy-eye, dibba-dobba, die-do. Whoop, diddy-umma, dumma, diddy-umma, day. Oh, diddy-bumma, 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 day. Diddy-dum, diddy-bo, diddy-dum, diddy-do. Whoop, diddy-whoop, whoop, diddy-bumma, day.
Now we can do that last bit again, and we want everybody to join in. All right? Here we go. And it goes. That'll do.
Welcome two brilliant young men from Belgium who won the first prize at this year's Circus Festival in Paris. Their combination of skill and comic talent is quite bewildering. Watch Les Frères Taquin. Assured that lady wasn't part of the act, no one was more surprised than her when she was called onto the stage.
Once there was a king who was very fond of wearing new clothes. One day, two swindlers came to sell him what they said was a magic suit. Now, to tell you the truth, there really wasn't any magic suit. But the swindlers said, "Oh, your majesty, this is a magic suit. Naturally, since you're very wise and intelligent, you can see how beautiful it is. But to a fool, it's absolutely invisible." "I see," said the king, and not wanting to appear a fool, he added, "Isn't it grand? Isn't it fine? Look at the cut, the style, the line. The suit of clothes is altogether, but altogether, it's altogether the most remarkable suit of clothes that I have ever seen. These eyes of mine at once determine the sleeves of velvet, the cape is ermine, the hose of blue, and the doublet is a lovely shade of green. Lovely shade of green, lovely shade of green." Ah, and the king issued information. "Isn't it grand? Isn't it fine? But the cut, the style, the line. The suit of clothes is altogether, but altogether, it's altogether the most remarkable suit of clothes a tailor ever made. Now quickly put it all together with gloves of leather and hat to feather. It's altogether the thing to wear in Saturday's parade.
Saturday's parade,
leading the royal brigade." Now, by that time, everyone had heard about the king's new clothes and that he was going to wear them in the parade. The people lined the streets, and finally, the king came by, and everybody cheered, for nobody wanted to appear a fool. Nobody, that is, except for one little boy who hadn't heard about the king's new clothes and didn't know what he was supposed to see. He took one look and exclaimed, "Look at the king! Look at the king! Look at the king! The king! The king! The king!"
"King is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, he's altogether as naked as the day that he was born.
The king is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, he's altogether the very least the king has ever worn. Call an intermission! Call a court physician! His majesty is wide open to ridicule and scorn.
The king is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, it's altogether the very least the day when he was born. And it's all too cold, Julia Moore.
Snow White girl is such a pest. But the glass will tell us who's the best. I'll try my magic spell to cast, and then we'll know the truth at last. Mirror, mirror on the wall, Who is the fairest one of all?
With a smile and a song, life is just like a bright sunny day. Your cares fade away and your heart is young. There's no use in grumbling when raindrops
said that.
Well, I knew I heard it somewhere. Boy!
You know you're an old fool.
What?
He's an old fool.
I am not.
He's an old fool. An old fool!
What did you call me?
Old fool. On with the show!
On with the show!
On with the show!
No, it's not Michael Jackson, but an amazing young man from America, Christopher.
Simple as old Remy, ABC, 1, 2, 3.
asked to introduce one of the acts this evening, they said, would you mind sharing a dressing room? Well, I said, naturally, I don't mind. I quite understand the situation. What I didn't realize was that there would be 23 of them. Now, quite simply, they are the most famous boys' choir in the world. And if the original members were here tonight, they would have to be something like 500 years of age, because that's how old the choir is. And during the history of the choir, they've been associated with some of the world's greatest composers, with Mozart, Schubert, and of course, Strauss. Now, very often they're referred to as the singing ambassadors of Austria, and I'm sure you'll give them a very big welcome tonight, the Vienna Boys Choir.
Show dedicated to Once Upon a Time, we meet the greatest storyteller of today, author of such wonderful books as James and the Giant Peach, The Witches and Matilda, Roald Dahl.
I will tell you a story, which is also a secret. Long, long ago, when I was writing Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, I got so in love with writing about nasty little blisters like Augustus Gloop and Veruca Salt and Violet Beauregard, that I got carried away and I put in many too many. And when I'd finished, I had to go back and take lots of them out. And this morning, I opened up this 30-year-old manuscript to see exactly what I had taken out. And the first one I came across was a girl called Miranda Mary Piker. And she was, her crime was that she was totally disobedient. If you asked her to sit down, she stood up. And if you asked her to stop talking, she began yelling. And so, of course, in the first version of the book, when she got into the chocolate factory, she had to be got rid of. And this was done by Mr. Wonka in having her fall into one of his giant peanut crunching machines. And while she was in there, floundering around in this hot caramel and roasting peanuts, and her parents were jumping up and down yelling, "Save her, save her," the Oompa Loompas began to sing a little song, which went like this. "Oh, Miranda Mary Piker, how can anybody like her? Such a rude and disobedient little kid. So we said, why don't we fix her in the peanut brittle mixer? Then we're sure to like her better than we did. Soon this child who was so vicious will have gotten quite delicious, and her parents will have surely understood that instead of saying, Miranda, oh, the beast, we cannot stand her, they'll be saying, oh, how crunchy and how good." Goodbye.
And now we join the Royal Shakespeare Company with a sequence from their successful production, The Wizard of Oz, with Dorothy, played by Imelda Staunton.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic way. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found, leading from your windowpane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the
place, Toto? Well, there must be. It's not a place you could get to by a boat or a train. It's far, far away, beyond the moon and behind the rain.
Life is sad, believe me, missy, if you're born to be a sissy without the vim and vine. But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had a knife. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion.
Aww.
Afraid I don't desire, but I could show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the knife.
Oh, you'd be in your stride, a king down to the core.
You could roar the way you never roared before.
And then I'd roar, and roar some more. I could show the dinosaurs who's king around the forest, a king in Venezuela. Why, with my regal Beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the knife. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard, well, sir,
then I'm sure to get a brain,
a heart,
a home,
the knife.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard of wits, if ever a wizard there was. If ever, oh, ever a wizard there was, the wizard of Oz is from because of the wonderful things he does.
We're off to see the wizard.
Imelda and her colleagues John Bow, Jim Carter and Paul Greenwood. And the full show returns to the Royal Shakespeare Repertory at the end of the year. And now America's top real-life wizard, Harry Blackstone.
If this is something that you've not seen before, may I invite you to watch and watch very carefully. It's designed to fool you. It has a bird in a cage, a canary. And while you're watching, our canary will disappear right from the tips of my fingers. And you'll not see where it goes. I hope. Hup! Now that the underwhelming applause is not on. Oh. I don't know if you heard the youngster in the front. He said, up your sleeve. Oh, you think so? Well, just for that, I'd like you to feel my sleeves. Come up here, son. You check the sleeves, both sleeves, all the way. Check it all the way. That's fine. The other one, too. And underneath my coat, madam, feel around, tell me what you can find. What do you mean, not much? Oh, no, you were a critic. Well, for those that were not watching quite carefully enough, or for the one or two that may not have known what to watch for, give me just a moment of your time. I'll step back into my office, get another cage, another canary, and I'll do that again. What? The other cage, right? This time, I'd like to invite someone else to hold on to this cage and canary, because both the bird and cage will disappear while you're holding it. May I invite about a half dozen of the children to come up? Any that would like to, boys or girls, come right along. Just a half a dozen or so, boys or girls. That's fine. That's all. Thank you. That's plenty. That's all. Thank you. That's plenty. Thank you very much. That's all. That's all. That's all. I have a feeling like I'm talking to my own children. Thank you. Now, boys and girls, please step back this way, away from the edge of the stage. You see, there's a rather deep area in the front of each stage, known in the theater as the pit. Please stay away from the pit. It's filled with alligators and musicians. And may I point out to you young ladies on stage, if you should fall into the pit, it's not the alligators you should worry about. I've met them all. Now, may I ask you, my dear, to put one of your hands on the front of the cage. One hand on the front of the cage. Your hand here on the end of your arm, on the front of the cage. That's... the young lady with the pink on, way on the end, would you step over this way, sweetheart? That's fine. Come right over here and you put your hand on the side of the cage. Right on my hand. That's nice. And you have a hand on the back of the cage, please. Yours on top of the cage. No, put the clean hand up there. Little lady right over there with the blue on, would you step over this way, sweetheart? You put your hand on the bottom of the cage. Put a lovely dress. Is it yours or your mother's? Nice. And the young man there, put your hand on the back of the cage. Now, you other boys and girls, come down this way. I want each of you to come up here, put a hand on the cage, especially the boy with the lovely hat. Come over this way. Oh, have to get that hat right on here. Watch the alligators. That's it. Put your hand on the front. Your hand on the side. Come over this way, sweetheart. You put your hand on the back of the cage. Yours on the top. Yours on the bottom. Yours on the other side. Yours on there. No, switch hands. You won't be all out of shape. Ha! Well, that's the way it goes. Thank you very much.
Lindemann,
my Lord Mayor, Lady Moress. My gracious Lord Mayor, good gracious Lady Moress.
Could we have a trial ha-ha, please? Trial ha-ha. One, two, three. Oh, is that it? They reckon if you can get a laugh on one of these shows, you can put your name down for a council house at the Falkland Islands. This. Lots of lovely boys and girls, it's all the kids are all enjoying the shows, they're all busy down there unscrewing the ashtrays, and they're all saying... They're all saying, when are the Diddy Men coming on, Dad? Would you like to see the Diddy Men, kids?
Yes!
Great, boys and girls, would you like to go to Diddy Land?
Yes!
Fine, off you go. Well... We've all got to make a magic wish. When I count three, everybody shout Diddy Men as loud as you can. One, two, three.
Yeah!
Is it? Is it? It isn't. It is.
D-I-D-D-Y. We are the Diddy Men, Dotty, Stotty, Diddy Men. We are the Diddy Men who always have a bash. We're full of Diddy joys, we make a gay and Diddy noise. We are the Diddy Men who come from Naughty Ash. In Diddy socks, Diddy shoes, Diddy hats, Diddy shoes, around the Diddy city, we sing our Diddy Diddy. We are the Diddy Men, Dotty's Dotty Diddy Men. We are the Diddy Men who come from Naughty Ash.
So here's Mick the Marmalizer. He's 2'7" tall, and with his 6-inch shillelagh, sure he marmalize you all. Here's Evan from the valley. He's travelled very far. So for all the Diddy Welshmen, here's a Diddy Yaki Dar.
We are the Diddy Men, Dotty's Dotty Diddy Men. We are the Diddy Men who come from Naughty Ash.
From Inver Cocky Leaky, wee Hamish, that's his name. He's only got a Diddy Sporran, but he wiggle it just the same. Here's Nigel Ponsonby Smallpiece, the cream of the elite. Just follow him and you will see his Diddy country seat.
We are the Diddy Men, Dotty's Dotty Diddy Men. We are the Diddy Men who come from Naughty Ash. Our Diddy hearts are dutiful, our tummies are jambuntiful. In accents many and various, we're feeling touchy for Laris. Merry and gay, wherever we are. A Diddy for lay, a Diddy for love. We are the Diddy Men, Dotty's Dotty Diddy Men. We are the Diddy Men, so let the cymbals crash. We're the Diddy Men from Naughty Ash.
And jambutty nibbler, Nigel Ponsonby Smallpiece. Oh, I say, Nigel, when you hit that topsy, that was absolutely...
Oh, Marmalaysia! Oh, Marmalaysia!
Oh, Marmalaysia!
Lift your heads up, you big chicken!
That lovely Kensington Grammar School. You can't... you can't marmalise all these posh people here tonight.
Why are those going to stop me?
Because they're all sports people. These are all Saturday sportsmen. They're all supporters of the greatest, the finest, the most fabulous football team in the whole world, Liverpool!
Everton!
Rubbish. We support Naughty Ash Rovers. Oh, we good. We support the little Diddy team, Naughty Ash Rovers, and one day we'll get to Wembley and we'll win the cup, the Egg Cup. We will. We'll be on that turf at Wembley and we'll win 99-0. You'll score the winning goal. This is our secret dribbler. We only found out last night. This. And after the game, we'll take the cup and we'll have a party in a big London hotel with stars from all over the world. And it'll be a beautiful day like today, because hasn't today been a beautiful day, kids?
Yay!
It's just the sort of lovely day to go on a Diddy Dizzy holiday.
The buggy lines are closing, the buggy lines are shut. The happy little Diddy Man is doing his bit. And it's up we go, when the buggy wins his club. We're going on a Diddy holiday. With our swimming things and the Diddy water wings, we're going on a Diddy holiday. Far and near we'll hear the happy screeches when the beach is in sight. And as long as the weather's fair to middling,
how are you diddling, kids?
All right! We've got some money thanks to our Diddy Piggy Banks for all the slot machines along the road. We'll be dumping back martinis in our Diddy Pink Bikinis. We're going on a Diddy holiday.
should sing song. And long as the wedding's pantomiming, how you diddling kids? We want some money, thanks to our dinky dinky banks, for all the slot machines along the bay. We'll be knocking back martinis in our gay pink bikinis. It's time to leave the city for somewhere gay and pretty. We're going on a dinky holiday. We're going on a dinky holiday. Yes, we're going on a dinky
evening. Nice to see you. The music industry is a hotbed of dreams and of ambitions. Some of them come to nothing, some of them, they're there overnight. And the band I'm about to introduce you to, in actual fact, were bold enough to say, when will I be famous? And it happened pretty well overnight. Their first album went platinum within 2 weeks. Nowadays, they're just sort of jamming. They're jamming switchboards, they're jamming streets, they're jamming their record company, and they're jamming their fan club. Here to sing I Owe You Nothing, please welcome Bross!
Is Nikki from Neighbours.
Well, I suppose I should say g'day.
I must say that it's absolutely wonderful to be here on this really special night. Are you enjoying yourself?
Yeah!
Great. Do you like fairy tales?
Yeah!
Well, so do I, and I love pantomime also, so that's why I was really pleased when they asked me to introduce this next scene from Cinderella. So, could I please ask you to welcome Michael Barrymore as Buttons and Jessica Martin as Cinderella, who's just found out that she won't be going to the ball.
I suggest what?
No, Buttons, I'm not all white.
What's up, Cinders?
Those sisters made me tear up my ticket. There's no way I can go to the ball.
Oh, come on, Cinders. Look, hey, look, I've got an idea. Look, you used to do this when we were kids, you remember? You used to get a piece of paper and you rip it up and you make it like a jigsaw puzzle, you see? And then you hand it in at the ball and it just... Come on, Cinders, it's not the end of the world.
Oh, yes, Buttons, it is.
Oh, no, come on, Cinders, look. If you can't go to the ball, then we'll have our own ball here, yes? Come on, up you get. Look, I'll show you. First of all, you need a dress. There we are. It's not the Emmanuel's, but it's a lot cheaper. There you go. And now you need a necklace. One necklace. There we are. Look at that, Cinders. 14 carat. There we go. And a tiara. There we are. There you go, Cinders. Look at that. You look just like an Arsenal supporter now. There.
Oh, thank you, Buttons. You're wonderful.
Oh, I'm never going to wash my face again.
I mean it.
Oh, I'm never going to wash that hand
again. You're the greatest.
Oh, that one. Cinders.
Buttons, what are you doing?
Well, I was hoping to never have to take a bath again.
Buttons.
Yes, Cinders.
I've got a secret.
A secret? A secret. She says she's got a secret.
A secret, I've got a little secret. I'll make it for to shout it to every daffodil and tell the world about it. In fact, I think I will. If this isn't love, the whole world is crazy.
If this isn't love, I'm daft as a daisy.
We're swinging on stars. I'm riding on rainbows. We're busting with bliss, and I'll kiss your hand if this isn't love. If this isn't love, the whole world is crazy.
The whole world's crazy.
If this isn't love,
yeah.
I'm daft as a daisy.
She's daft as a daisy.
And I'll kiss your hand if this isn't love. Oh, Buttons, that's really cheered me up.
Oh, good, Cinders.
Oh, but there's still one special person I'd love to see at the ball.
Yeah?
And I bet you he hasn't got a ticket either.
No, he hasn't, no.
Oh, Buttons, I've got to tell you my secret. I'm in love.
In love? Well, what's he like?
Well, he's tall.
What, like me?
Like you, Buttons. And he's got these laughing, twinkling eyes.
Well, like mine are.
Oh, exactly.
Oh, Cinders, come over here, quick. I've got something to tell you. I've got a secret.
Really?
I'm in love.
Who with?
With you.
Oh, Buttons, I love you.
Yeah, I know, you just said I heard you over there.
But I'm not in love with you. No, I'm in love with someone else. Oh, he's gorgeous, isn't it great?
Somebody else. I just naturally assumed that when you were talking...
Buttons, I'm sorry.
No, go.
Buttons, please.
No, alone, Sinners, please. You go away from me. You leave me alone, Sinners. You just get out of my life, please. I don't want to be Sinners. I don't want to be Sinners. There is nothing going to be. No, you can't have one of them. Oh, Sinners, please. Don't leave me, Sinners, for God's sake. No, Sinners.
What is it?
You're standing on me foot. Now get up. Now, Sinners, you can't do this. Sinners, I mean, you just got to be reasonable. I mean, people have feelings, you know, Sinners. And some people have little feelings, and some people have medium-sized feelings, and some people have big feelings. Well, I had a big feeling for you, and I wouldn't give you that. It's just a little feeling, because I know what people are like, Sinners. You just can't destroy somebody like that, Sinners. It's not fair. Well, you can do what you like, Sinners, because I know where I am, and I can do it. I know Mr. Grimscale. There's no way, Sinners. You've got to get out of here. Just get out of my life, Sinners. You leave me alone. There's nothing. I got to want no, Sinners, for God's sake. No, I don't want to be there, there's nothing. I know what it's going on. Right, I know what I'm not wanting. I think I'd better go to bed. Maybe 5 hours or less.
Oh, Buttons?
Yes, Sinners?
Thanks for being my friend.
Okay, I'll be your friend, okay? It's fine. Yeah, rabbits. They have a great time of it, rabbits. I've got a... He's got a rabbit. Nice of him, isn't it? Right in the middle of a serious scene, he's got a rabbit. I mean, you might be with somebody important. You might be a proper rabbit. Yes. She's got a rabbit. It's a proper rabbit. Yes, I know. Did you bring this person, Mum? Might as well reach into the depths now, might we? Hey, diddle diddle, the cat did a piddle. All over the kitchen mat. The little dog laughed to see such fun, so we piddled all over the cat. That's it. That's what they like, the southern stuff. Right, I'll pop downstairs, see if there's anybody down there, then we'll worry about the rest.
Oh, for goodness sake, Basil. Get up.
Sybil, do you have to spoil every scene I try?
It's not easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves, when I think it might be nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not easy being green. Seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over, 'cause you're not standing out like flashy sparkles in the water or stars in the sky. But green's the color of spring, and green can be cool. And green can be big, like a mountain, or important, like an ocean, or tall like a tree. When green is all there is to be, it could make you wonder why, but why wonder? Why wonder? I'm green. It'll do fine. It's beautiful. And I think it's what I want to be.
Ribbit. gentlemen, when I was a youngster of about 7 or 8 years of age, I saw a moment of magic that was not only memorable, but perhaps something I'll never forget. May I recreate it for you? It'll be something you'll remember the longest day you live. See it over there. Let me bring it to you so that you may see it. It's rather dark here. Glad I brought my own light. You'd like to look at it? Of course, please take it, look at it, examine it. And now that you've looked at it and looked at it rather carefully, may I show you and you the impossible. And perhaps you'd like to see it as well, madam. Please take it. She says, that's impossible. Of course it's impossible, my dear. That's why we do it. Just let go. And perhaps you'd like to look at it. Sheared her out of a year's growth. Like to see it as well. I'll tell you what, if I let you look at it, promise just to look, don't touch. All right, then you may see it as well.
Thank you.
Joker, Joker, the Joker is me. There's always a Joker in the pack. There's always a cardboard clown. The poor painted fool falls on his back, and everyone laughs when he's down. There's always a funny man in the game, but he's only funny by mistake. And everyone laughs at him just the same. They don't see his painted heart break. They don't care as long as there is a jester. Just a fool, as foolish as he can be. There's always a joker, that's the rule. But fate deals the hand and I see. The Joker is me, the Joker is me, the Joker is me.
Thank you.
terrific!
I love knockabout comedians.
Well, that's because you're a comedian who's been knocked about a bit.
Would you trust them to decorate your house?
I wouldn't trust them to decorate a cake.
Yeah, but they're funny, though.
Oh, funny.
This is the world of Dr. Doolittle. Wonderful world of Dr. Doolittle. Where crocodiles talk and elephants sing.
And animals do most any old thing.
Where polar bears wear top hats. And elephants box wear spats. Well, that's life in the world of Dr. Doolittle. Ducks start to coo when they see Doolittle. He has a profound philosophy. If animals can't be friends, says he, well then, why can't we? And here comes Dr. Doolittle.
If we could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting to a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting to a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. We could converse in polar bear and python, and we would curse in fluent kangaroo. If people asked us, can you speak rhinoceros? We'd say, of course-us, can't you? If we conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of all the things we could discuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. And we are sure every octopus, place and platypus, certainly would see it as a plus. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. We'd study every living creature's language, so we could speak to all of them on sight. If friends said, can you talk in crab or pelican? We'd say like helicon, and we'd be right.
And if we all spoke like animals, who need English? Gradually we'd drop it with no fuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could squeak and squawk and speak and talk to us.
I've seen the world, I've been around, I can tell you stories that quite astound you. I'm not a fool, I went to school, I've been from Liverpool to Istanbul, Istanbul. I'm no fool, and anyone will tell you that I'm sharper than a knife.
But I've never seen anything like it in my life. No, I've never seen anything like it. Never seen anything like it. I've never seen anything like it in my life.
I thought I'd seen every wonder in the world. I've seen the Colosseum in Rome and the Acropolis. I made the biggest blunder in the world, because I've never seen anything quite like this. I'm down to earth, I'll tell you straight, I can tell you stories that fascinate you. I know the trade, I know the tricks. I once bought an elephant for £2.06.
£2.06.
Taught it tricks, but all this push you pull you, I pay £3, £4, £5.
Cause I've never seen anything like it, that's a lie. No, I've never seen anything like it. Never seen anything like it. I've never seen anything like it in my life. Thank you.
Jumpity-doo-dah, jumpity-yay. Wonderful feeling, wonderful day.
NSPCC, Mr. Kevin Jones, who's the chairman and chief executive of Mothercare, now has a cheque to present for the sum of £69,000 to Her Royal Highness the Princess Margaret.
Gentlemen, may we have three plumptious cheers for Her Royal Highness the Princess Margaret. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
The show was now over for the audience, but for the artist there was still the most exciting moment of all. Presentations to Her Royal Highness backstage. First, she's presented to John Fisher, who devised and produced the evening's entertainment. John, in turn, introduces Brian Rogers, who staged the show. And so another children's Royal Variety performance comes to a happy close.
Well, you may like to know that Ken Dodd will be a guest on Open Air on Thursday morning. If you'd like to talk to him about any of his television work, well then please phone 061 814 0424 now. The lines will be open until 10 o'clock.
Well, you know, Sir George, since we filmed that special happy birthday, a last-minute leave of absence from studying was granted, and she can be with you after all, your daughter, Gabrielle. In fact, briefly, Sir George, you broke a tour of Germany when Gabrielle was born, flying back to London to be there at the birth, then back to Berlin to conduct Falstaff, and at the final curtain call, much to your surprise, Sir John Falstaff steps forward, hands behind his back. The audience wondered what was happening.
You've received awards the world over, George, but tonight I thought you should get something a bit special.
Your great friend of more than 25 years and now retired from his much-acclaimed international opera career, Sir Geraint Evans. So, Geraint, how did you decide to mark your friend here becoming a father?
Well, the lady in black, George's secretary for many years, came to us 3 hours before the performance and said, George has just had a baby daughter. So we thought we'd better do something. So the shops were closing in half an hour, so we decided to rush around Berlin looking for something. And at the final curtain call, we presented him with a baby.